Hello everybody, today I am doing a PS Live. God, I already fucked it up. Doing a PS Live, I know I said I'll be doing a PO Live, but I lied because I'm a filthy fucking liar. I'm doing a PS Live because I just feel like doing PS over PO because I have like a bit more rank on here so I can just get hopefully better games. I did just try and record one and I just kept getting butt fucked by hacks, so what I've done is I've moved to another account where I have a higher ranking. Hopefully I won't be against people running Brick Break Dragonite, because that is one of the things that just hacks me out, so that's always a fun time. But yeah, so that's basically what I've got going on. I've got a Mega Pinsir based team, obviously standard Mega Pinsir, standard Air Balloon Excadrille for rapid spinning purposes, a Choice Scarf Magneton. I use Magneton over Magazone because it's faster, it can outspeed Greninja, which this team has a bit of a problem with, and shite like that as well. Yeah, and it traps, obviously, the problematic steel types like Skarmory and Ferrothorn. Standard physically defensive Landorus T, Azumarill, Assault Vest, once again for Greninjas and such, and an Amoonguss, which is used for checking opposing Azumarills, because Azumarill can pose a massive threat problem for this team, but I have got enough. Basically, if it sets up a BD, I can live one hit as long as I'm at full, even after rocks damage, and just take him down with Sludge Bomb. So that's basically the team. And yeah, hopefully we'll get some decent games as opposed to some just shit I've been putting up with just now. So yeah, okay, so instantly we have found a game, but this guy's an Entei, so that's pretty interesting, and Nimpoleon, but I'm not going to judge because could be threatening. This is a threat, definitely. I don't know what he's going to lead with, though. Probably Landorus, to be honest. I can't fire off Volt Switches freely because of that, so that's always a pain in the arseus, but I'm going to lead with my own Landorus, expecting him to lead with his Landorus. That's exactly what he leads with. I think he's going to be Scarf, because it doesn't look like he has any other viable Scarfs on his team. The only other viable Scarfer is potentially Heracross, but we all know that's going to be Mega, so I'm just going to set up my Stealth Rocks right away, because he has two things weak to them, and his Empoleon is weak to my Earthquake. So, yeah, that's his only default. Actually, that's a lie, that's not his only default. He has Latias potentially as well, but looking at it, the only reason you run Empoleon is for default support, I think. But who knows, he might be running it on both. But either way, he does U-turn out straight away, which suggests to me that he may be Scarf, because I feel like if he was defensive, he would have probably tried to get up his own rocks there. But it's early days yet. Let's just see what he wants to do. He does go straight into Entei. This thing is annoying because of that one move that it gets and spams all the time. So I'm just going to go straight for an Earthquake. I don't care that I'm at minus one and going to be burnt. I'm not burned. Oh my god, that does nothing. What the hell, Entei? I'm surprised how much that Sacred Fire did, to be honest. Yeah, I have nothing that really wants to take a banded Sacred Fire from an Entei. Yeah, nothing on my team can take it. I have like, whoa, do I have one, two, three? I have four things weak to fire. Wow, I'm a bad team builder. It's not like, to be fair, there's like no decent fire types up in this tier, so. Entei, why are you a threat? I might want to keep this for his Heracross, so what do I not need? Magneton can trap that. Excadrill. Does he even have hazards on his team? I don't think so. I might sack Excadrill, because I'm not seeing what it does to his team. Yeah. Best sack is that. But yeah, she goes into his Landorus. I guess not wanting to let his Entei die yet. But this works fine, but he's just going to U-turn out, so best thing I can do is go into something that resists that. That is going to be my... I'm going to go into Landorus again. Because, oh, he actually knocks off. That's cool. Considering he's almost definitely locked into that and at minus one now, I'm just going to go straight into Pinsir. Actually, no, I'm going to U-turn. I'm not going to go straight into Pinsir. I'm going to U-turn out first. I don't like the fact that my Landris is getting weakened, but I get initiative on him regardless of what happens now. So he just goes into Latias on my U-turn, which is... Oh, I didn't go for U-turn. Why? How much lag was there? I literally cancelled like 3 days ago. that's fine. I have a Azumarill which can eat up hits from this thing. Hopefully, yep, eating up that Draco Meteor like it's nothing. That's because it is nothing, ladies and gentlemen. oh my god. I'm so unfunny. Okay, his most likely switch is Empoleon. I'm going to go for a knockoff because it will hopefully do decent damage. And it does do okay damage. He's almost definitely some sort of defensive variant. I'm going to go straight into Magneton because I can trap this thing. Even if he goes for Defog, it's not a problem. I can Volt Switch out and get a switch straight into... he actually just Stealth Rock, so that's perfect. I can just Thunderbolt, hopefully take him out. If it doesn't take him out, that's annoying. Does take him out. Wonderful. So he hopefully does not have Defog for the rest of the game, and I do have still have my spinner left, so I don't know what I get a spin off on though. Nothing really. Hurrah. Goes straight into Entei. That's great, because I am scarfed and he doesn't seem to realise that. So get out of here, Entei, no one likes you. Okay, wonderful. Now he goes into Landorus, realizing that I am in fact scarfed. Gonna risk the earthquake. Wait, I'm going to risk it and just go into Excadrill, hoping he goes for an Earthquake. He does not. He goes for the U-turn. That is annoying, because I would have liked to get off a free free Rapid Spin on that. But you can't have everything, I'm afraid. But I should be able to outspeed this Heracross if it's Mega, which I'm assuming it is. So, gonna have to sec. gonna have to do it. I can luckily get off an Intimidate, so yeah, he just goes for the Rock Blast, expecting my switch into this, which is good play on his part. But wait, this thing like sweeps him. No, that's a lie, he still has Landorus. But he has no switch into return. But regardless, I'm going to go straight into this, because if he's adamant, which all of them are, I can outspeed him and just go for a Rapid Spin, because I'm adamant as well. But I'm pretty sure I can outspeed him, because no one runs Jolly Mega Heracross. You run Mega Heracross to destroy everything, so I'm just going to go for the Rapid Spin, get that off, which is awesome, because that means my Pinsir can now come in for absolutely free, and just start tearing people's assholes open. So, yeah, oh my god, I'm so crude. Right, okay, yeah, just go straight into this, and... One wants to die, friend. It's probably just going to be this, to be honest. Yeah, he just lets this die, which is cool by me. He goes straight into his Lando. I'm not really sure. Actually, no, he's just going to go straight for a Stone Edge, most likely. Going to go into Amoonguss, because Amoonguss can take a hit if it's a Stone Edge. He actually did Earthquakes. Did he predict that? Wait, I didn't knock him off, did I? No. I could go straight back into Hera, but I feel like that's really obvious. I'm going to go for a Spore. Let me just put something to sleep. Yeah. Night-night. Oh, night-night. Sweet prince. And Azumarill is my best play because I can just go straight for a player off. And once again, something on his team just has to die. So, yeah, he's just going to let his Latias die, which is awesome because that thing was a big threat. And I think this thing like cleans up his team. Yeah, he realizes that, so he's just going to get out of there. And, yeah, I've won a game. Woohoo. So let's look for another one, and hopefully we can get a couple more decent ones. I'm going to only go for like 20 minutes today, because it is like midnight, just hit midnight. I decided that at like 11:30 I wanted to go get Chinese, because I'm really hungry, I just don't feel good today. But I wanted to do this anyway, but this guy has Baton Pass of some kind, which isn't ideal at all. This is problematic to say the least. Can I just go into Pinsir and just... Can I just leave with Pinsir and just bop something with return? I'm going to do that. I'm going to hope he leads with... Fuck! Everything's going wrong already. I was hoping he'd leave with Scolipede, of course, but Azumarill is, I suppose, going to have to be the switch in to this Latios. Latios. Yes, Latios. My boy Latios. Yeah, going to have to be. I can take one Thunderbolt, maybe, unless he specs. I remember I just saw some guy with Energy Ball earlier, and it did like 55%. I was like, what the fuck? It turned out he was specs with Energy Ball. I laughed. Okay, yeah, so in comes the zoom reel. He does just go, he's, okay. This is a thing. I'm just gonna knock off. He's gonna have memento, I bet you now. I put money on him having memento with dual screens. Ooh, that is sad. That's depressing, yeah. Oh, knockoff did nothing. Yeah, light clay. Oh dear, this could be a problem. Yeah, he's gonna go for memento. Watch him. Yeah, called it. Oh! Mystical. Leader of innovation, 2014-2015. Right up into Auras. But, okay, this thing is starting to pose as a threat now. No, it's okay, I've still got this. Oh, fuck me. Fuck me. Okay, well, can I just SD? No. Go straight for this return. Oh my god, why did that do nothing? Why did that do literally zero? What the fuck? Oh my god, Espeon's gonna receive this and it's gonna be the most fucking annoying thing in the world. Just gotta go for another return, sadly. Oh my god, this is disgusting. Who runs this? I don't even have Clear Smog and Amoonguss, so I can't even do that. Ah, shit. Well, I have a Azumarill who might be able to take a hit from Espeon, but we're gonna have to see. He's subbing up. This is depressing. I'm gonna quick attack. Hopefully break the sub. Ah, this is bad. Why do people use this? Oh yes, the reflect goes away. Now my attacks will be doing nothing instead of zero. They'll be doing minimal damage instead of zero damage. Why is he doing this? Should I SD? No, that's a bad idea. Come on. Yeah, here we go. Bat and pass. In comes Espeon. Why did that do so little? That should not be doing that little. Oh my god. Well, in comes Azumarill. It's going to have to be Azumarill. And I'm going to have to hope to god that I can take a couple of hits. Oh my god. Who runs this? Who actually thinks, yeah, I'm going to do this today? Fucking cancer. Oh my god, this is... Who thinks this is a good idea, honestly? Right, only option, go into Magneton. Hope that I can live a stored power and hit him with Thunderbolt. And there's nothing I can do from there, so yeah. Bat and pass is such a shitty strategy. The only bat and pass that's acceptable is just going for one boost, then passing it on to something. Not getting a trick. Yes, you deserve that. Oh, if I got the power out, I would have been the happiest person in the world. That would have been the funniest thing. Don't you say ouch to me, you piece of shit. Get the power, come on. Nope. You know what, I'm bored of this. This is just cancer. I shouldn't say that word, but I don't care. Like, people who do that just kill yourself. Right, I'm going to lead with Magneton because it's my best lead against this. He doesn't have any form of ground type or electric immunity or electric electric immunity or electric, like, absorber for, like, you know, Manectric or whatever. That's what I mean by that. So, yeah, I can do that. And I believe I outspeed Talonflame as well. So, yeah, I think I outspeed Talonflame, so I can hit that with a Bolt Switch. But he actually leads with his Rotom Heat. Not ideal, because I don't want him to go straight for Overheat. But at the same time, I feel like he's going to Volt Switch turn one. I don't want to lose this, because it's like, it's really important, so, I'm going to go into Amoonguss. I know this seems like a dumb play, but I don't really need Amoonguss for anything on his team. He goes for Will-O-Wisp, so that means he's not Scarfed, I'm assuming. But he's definitely going for, yeah, he's definitely going for the overheat here, so I'm just going to go into this to tank it. He actually misses, which is worse for me than it is for him, because that means he gets, like, a free Willow off on me. Fuck's sake, this thing is so annoying. Why do I have nothing for this? Okay, fuck it, I'm just going to have to go back into this. Oh, he Volt Switches out, that's cool. I don't mind that. I do not mind that at all. I'd rather this thing be out of here, but he just goes straight into Clef on a balloon. just when I said, oh, we might have some decent games, we get Clef on a blue. What? Can someone explain to me why that's a good idea? Can anyone know? Clef on a balloon. Why? Why run it on a balloon? Why? Just why? That's my one. Why? Just why? Please tell me. If you tell me why, I will accept it. But if you give me a legitimate, fair reason why you would run that as a set, I will not criticize you. But please tell me why. Please. I need to know what the advantage of air balloon on Clefable is. I'm eating up that. Oh, look at that. Look at that waterfall damage. Crisp, as some would say. Why is that? Actually, that did nothing. What the fuck? I'm going to go into Magneton, because he's going to go for Softboard, and I can just hit him up with a Flash Cannon. Oh, not Thunderbolt. Flash Cannon. He's probably just going to go to Rotom. Yeah. Fucking hell, this thing is so annoying. Why is this a thing? Just got to go into Amoonguss, just let it die to an overheat. Ouch. I'm going to Exeter. I'm just be real, go straight for the earthquake. Hope he doesn't know what Mulbreaker is. Yeah, let's just hope he doesn't know what Mulbreaker is, and I can hopefully hit him up with a nice earthquake. And get this one thing that like seems to stop my entire team. But it's alright, I didn't really need Amoonguss for anything anyway. I should switch Amoonguss out, it does nothing for my team. I just needed a bulky grass type. I should probably put Meganium on there or something. That's actually not a bad idea. No, yeah it is. Mike, don't go down that path. But he just goes into Clef, that's not a great play. Okay, cool. Just gonna drop you with a 9 head. Don't have like Matt. Don't be Scarf, please. Oh no, wait, he had Air Balloon. I already discussed this with myself in length about how depressed I was. What is he doing? You trying to get the Flame Body? Brother. Just let me... Yes! Yes! The one thing that was like stopping my team. Gone! Get out! I bet he's thinking to himself, why did that kill? Why did that hit? Oh my god, I hate this game. Okay. Lucky I still have a Chector Bird sitting in the back, so should be alright. Yeah, this thing's a threat. That's alright, I still got a couple of checks. I've still got this, Banterous. Yeah, because I have Rock Slide specifically for this thing, because it's just such a broken mon. No one else seems... Actually, no, it's not Talonflame I'm thinking of. Greninja is broken. I don't know why no one else seems to think that Greninja is, like, ridiculously broken. I should Stealth Rock because he has no default. Actually, no, Scissor might be a default. I'm just going to Rock Slide. He might just go for another Flare Blitz. Considering how he's been playing, it wouldn't shock me, but he actually just goes straight into Clef, which eats up that Rock Slide like it's nothing. And take him out with Earthquake. So, that's the famous Air Balloon Clefable out of here, but he goes into the Ninja. Going to have to go into Azu. Don't want to have to risk playing around with mind games and shit. It's going to go straight into this. It's the safest play I can make. He has Surf, which is fair enough, like, if you don't want to miss. But I would personally run Skull, because it's only 10 base power weaker, and it has that swaggy, disgusting burn chance. Just going to... Could I knock off or a play rough? Not a play rough. Eating up that grass, not like it's nothing. Please hit. Yes! Azumarill, my boy! Okay, well, Talonflame's in. I'm just going to go for an Aqua Jet. Yeah, he does go for Brave Bird. That's fine. I know that he is banded because of how much damage he did to my max... dude, so I'm just going to go straight for a Volt Switch because he cannot hit me with Brave Bird. It won't hurt too much. And, yeah, I can go into Exeggutor here. Exeggutor's a good switch in. Or is it? No. I'll do it anyway. Sadly, I don't have Sam Rush. I have the Mold Breaker, as we saw earlier, but just going to go straight for Earthquake. It hits his TTR hard, and I can outspeed him. Regardless of whether he is Mega or not, because he hasn't Mega Evolved yet. This actually might be Mega. No, he's probably got Mega Sizzle, to be honest. I think Mega Sizzle's superior to Mega T-Tar, but I... What the hell does anyone care what I think? I'm only some kid on the internet. Yes, you guys... I did not expect him to go into Sizzle. I expected him to go straight into Talonflame, because I have Magneton, who can just HP trap this with HP Fire, but... I don't need this anymore, so I'm just going to go for Earthquake, do as much damage as I possibly can, because I'm adamant max attack. That means I have, 405 attack. That's mental. Excadrill, you crazy? I did nothing. Oh my god. What the fuck? Wow. Oh my god, that was hilariously low damage. What the fuck? Jesus. That was pitiful damage. I'm pretty sure a pillow being thrown at his head would probably do more than that. Okay, well, I'm just going to have to rock slide. Flare Blitz, yep, that's cool. Just weigh yourself down. Yes, weigh yourself down. And now I'm just going to go into this and just get up my rocks real quick. Is that a good idea? Yeah. Yeah, I'm just going to do that. And then you turn out. Because I can outspeed him. If he defogs, that's fine. Yeah, I'm pretty sure this game is in the bag. If he U-turns out now, that's fine, but he's probably going to defog. That's fine, as I said, because I have trapped him now. HP Fire, I think, will kill, because he's not even at 50. Yeah, he wasn't even at 75%. That was easily going to kill. And now, yeah, he's just forced to spam Flare Blitz, but he does not decide to do that. He's just going to forfeit right there. I'm just going to go for one more game, and then that'll be it for the day, I think. Okay, so I'm against some guy, 123 Pro. The Pro makes... Oh no, P-O, I thought it was Pro. okay, well he is an Amoonguss as well, so Amoonguss friends, but... Does he have a ground type? Yes, he has this one. Oh, fucking hell. Leads. This, or this. Azumarill. Go, do me proud. Please do not leave with Amoonguss. Yes, perfect. Well, the likelihood is he's gonna go straight into Amoonguss now, so I'm gonna go for a knockoff, just to start wearing that thing down just a little bit at least. And now he is free to go for a Spore, but luckily I do have my own Amoonguss who can tank said Spore because I am a Grass type, and Grass types are not affected by Powder moves in this generation because 6th gen changed so many things. And he just goes straight for Foul Play. I'm not sure what the... He probably knew my Amoonguss was coming in. He probably wanted to get as much damage off on that as he could. Which is fair enough. I can't knock that, I suppose. But... the switch in here... I don't know. Is he going to stay in and just Sludge Bomb? I'm going to Foul Play. Because if he goes into... I'm thinking he's either going to go... Either going to go into Talonflame or Excadrill. Actually, that's probably a bad play. Yeah, I was going to say, he's probably going to go into Tyranitar. But I'm bad, so I don't know what I'm doing. But he does not look to be Lefty's Tar, so he's either Assault Vest or, worse, scarier, Megatar. Megatar could be a problem, so I'm just going to go straight into this. He is Megatar, he's probably going to DD. He actually has Fire Blast, that's very cool. He's probably, I guess, Boa then. Yeah, probably Boa of some kind, like mixed. I want Earthquake, but he has two Levitators, so my best play is probably just to U-turn. He actually stays in, making the ballsy play. That means he's going for Ice Beam, for sure. So, gonna go into this, eat it up. He actually Stealth Rocks, that's ballsy on his part. I'm going to play rough. I'm going to roughly play with him. That sounds really dirty, I'm sorry I had to put that image into your head. Ladies and gents, but I'm just going to go straight for player off, because if he goes to Amoonguss, it's fine. I'm still getting damage off on it. I didn't want to risk him staying in, predicting my not like my switch, so yeah. It's basically what I was going for, but Pinsir actually like butt-raped his team, I just realised. Like, he has no switch ins for a turn. No, not at all, really. Why did my PS4 just turn on? Well, what's my PS4 doing? One sec. Okay, my fucking PS4 is possessed. What the hell? I have no idea what that was all about. It just turned itself on and ejected the disc. So that was weird. But either way, okay, don't rush me, friend. I'm with you. I'm just going to go back into my potato here. But he actually doubles out, predicting that into his Talonflame. Good play on his part. Good show, old chap. This guy apparently knows what he's doing. He's going to try quite hard on us, so that's fun. I don't want to sack this yet, because it's my one Amoonguss switch in that I have. I need to keep Pinsir around, so... I don't know if he's going to Brave Bird or Flare Blitz, though, that's the thing. Because if he Flare Blitz, like, half my team does to Flare Blitz, that's the thing. That's the problem. Actually, I'm going to go into Landorus, because Landorus, I'm pretty sure, can take a hit. If he U-turns, that's cool, but no, he Flare Blitzes. Makes a smarter play. Do not burn me if he... Oh my god, if he burn me. People will be dying, but I'm just going to go straight for Stealth Rocks now, because Stealth Rocks are my best option. Yes, by far my best option. Because Excadrill is a threat that needs to be... No, sorry, yeah, Talonflame is a threat that needs to be stopped. So he goes into his Keld. Azumarill, once again, the safest play I can make. As he just goes for Icy Wind. Did not expect that. I personally would have gone for Surf or Scald there, but he's actually Life Orb, which is interesting. I haven't seen Life Orb Keldeo in a long time, but it's arguable that is actually one of its better sets, but... more than likely, he probably predicted my Amoonguss, which is why I went for that, but... Amoonguss is probably coming back in, isn't it? Most likely. Could I predict that? Or is he... Yeah, I'm going to predict that. Just go... Yes! Yes! Making plays up in here! Yay, boy! And now I can go straight for an Earthquake, because it's probably... Tyranitar's probably coming in, but at the same time, don't want to risk it. I'm just going to go straight for a return. I do still have my spinner in the back, but he's just going to leave his Amoonguss in, which dies. That is fantastic. Absolutely wonderful. Yes, that is... Ooh, that makes me a little bit wet. So, okay. I don't know what he's going to go for. Yeah, he just lost his one Azumarill switch in, so that is fucking wonderful. I need to switch into Excadrill. But what do I want to sack? Because I feel like my best sack is probably Amoonguss. I only needed Amoonguss for his Amoonguss. That doesn't make any sense, but... God, that Stone Age still did a lot. Holy shit. Tyranitar, you are so good. I'm going to Spore. Fire Blast might not be able to kill it. It actually doesn't. But the Burn and or the Sand will, so yeah. But my best play now is to go into Excadrill, because I can go straight for a Rapid Spin. There's nothing he can do to stop me. Yeah. That is by far my best play. Because then it leaves Excadrill open to rip more holes through his team, because he has nothing that can, like, switch in comfortably. So, Rapid Spin once. I hope he doesn't... If he breaks out of sleep first turn, we're going to have an issue, but should be okay. Yeah, he just goes straight into Keldeo. That's fine by me. I could have Earthquake there, but I didn't want to really risk it. I mean, his Keldeo's getting worn down enough by all these residuals anyway. Yeah. Azumarill is my ideal switch, but at the same time, he's probably going to predict that and go into something. But I don't know what he can go into. Alright. Could just go into Magneton and just risk it for shits and giggles. That's a bad idea. probably should have kept Amoonguss around now, but... Yeah, he's going straight for Scald. That is going to burn me, I guarantee it. Nope. Nice. He's probably going to stay in... No. Would he do that? Might do. Might just go for a Waterfall. Yes, I'm going to go straight for a Waterfall. Because I'm pretty sure Waterfall plus Sand plus... Actually, Sand won't be hitting him on this turn. But I'm pretty sure, yeah, Waterfall plus Aqua Jet plus Life Orb will be able to take him out. And if he goes out into Excadrill or Talonflame, they will not be able to take a Waterfall. But yeah, he just stays in as I thought he might. He does not get the burn again, which is absolutely fantastic. And I'm pretty sure Aqua Jet can take him out from this range. I'm going to have to risk it. Yes, it does. That is great, because that is another huge threat to my team down. But obviously, he still does have that Talonflame. But I'm just going to have to put up with it, sadly. But yeah, this doesn't grant him any free switches at all. Yeah, he's trying to get sand back up for his Xcar. I'm just going to go straight for another waterfall, take this thing out. Hopefully, oh my god, Tyranitar, you're bulky. Just going to Aqua Jet in case he wakes up. And yeah, now I've got to hope that... oh shit, I have nothing to take Flare Blitzes from Talon anymore. Okay, Excadrill, I'm just going to have to go for an Aqua Jet on. Shit. No, I should be alright actually. Maybe. Probably not. Actually, no. I'm alright actually. I think I'm alright. Because. Oh shit, I shouldn't have done that. I should have gone for Waterfall. No, it's okay. Okay. We'll quick attack take him out from that range. I've got to quickly calc it, so BRB. Okay, this might actually come down to a damage roll here. Quick attack from this range does 19 to 23%. So I have to hope for the best that this kills. And it does! That's wonderful. Absolutely fantastic. Yeah, Talonflame, you are a problem. Go away. Last Chance might actually be able to clean up my team, but I'm not gonna. Wait, I think Magneton outspeeds. I think it does actually. Wait, three. Oh shit, maybe not. No, if he's adamant, which he will be, yeah, okay. Think I may still have a chance, so I'm just gonna go straight into this. Let him kill me off. Let him rack up recall and stealth. That's cool. Did not need Excadrill whatsoever. Still may have a chance here. Potentially. Probably not though. yeah. Yeah, he suspects the timer that I've got that shit going on. He knows. This guy knows. Oh, I shouldn't have let my Azumarill die. Whoopsie daisy. Wait. I may be able to pull this off. That's amazing. That's literally the best thing he could have done. Yes. I think I may be able to clutch this now, guys. Because, oh shit, I shouldn't have gone into this. No, it's fine. Fuck. I may have just botched this. I should have gone into that and then quick attack. No, it's fine. It's fine. Shit, is it fine? Probably not. Wait, how much did Volt Switch do? 14%. 70. 105. 52. Oh no! Oh, that's cool. Okay. Gotta take Pinsir now. This is where he pulls out the sword stance. He pulls out the sword stance, turns out to be Jolly. Okay, I think Magneton has got this. Yeah, boy! Oh, that was a close game. Oh yeah, boy, that was awesome. Okay, that was a really good way to end it. God, I nearly had a heart attack there. But no, that was wonderful. Oh dear. Oh, yeah, definitely need to have my heart looked out after that. I think I nearly had a heart attack with that, but we did it. We pulled through. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed that. It's good to be back. Yeah, it is good to be back. I did actually fairly enjoy myself, so hope you guys did as well. And yeah, I will hopefully see you all very soon. Thank you very much.